Basically, you're going to make sure your equations are always stacked. Okay? When you stack those equations, you need to make sure that they are lined up. Meaning, I need to make sure that my x's are in line, my y's are in line, my equal signs are in line, and then my numbers without a variable are in line. Does everybody see that? Okay. For most of the problems we do to begin with, that is going to be done. Okay? I'm not going to make you rearrange and move to begin with because we just need to learn the process. Alright, after you stack them, the whole idea is you want to eliminate, that's why it's called the elimination method. Okay? You want to eliminate one of your variables by adding these two equations together. Okay? Now, if I were to add these two equations the way they are written, what is -10x + 2x? -8x. What happens right here to 2y and -2y? There is my eliminate. They eliminated. Does everybody see that? Okay, so I'm going to take my knife and I'm going to mark through it. It's like I cut my blueberry pancake. Okay? So that's no longer there. And then what is -14 + 22?
Negative 8.
Positive 8. Okay? So I have eliminated y just by adding my two equations together. How do I solve for x? You divide by -8 and x equals -1. That's your score. Now, the problem is how many variables, what else do I need?
Oh, we're not finished.
No. I still need a y, right? Okay, listen to me. I'm going to show you both ways. I won't show you both ways ever again, but I just want you to see that it doesn't matter. Okay? If I were to, all right, so we've already solved all this. Let me erase this. I'm going to write. Okay, I know that x is -1, right? So I'm going to plug -1 in for x, and it doesn't matter which equation you do that in. Okay? Guys, you can pick the top equation. Girls, you can pick the bottom equation. We should both get the same answer, and I'm going to show you that right now. But usually I pick the one with the smallest numbers because we're multiplying and adding and subtracting. Okay? And it's just easier. Okay. So -10 × -1 − 2y = -14. That's the top equation. 2 × -1 + 2y = 22. That would be the bottom equation, okay? All right, on the far side, what's -10 × -1?
Positive 10.
All right, what would I do now? Trying to get y by itself.
Oh, no, so you subtract 10.
I will move my 10, okay? So now I have -2y = -24. And what's my last step? Divide by -2 and y equals 12. Okay, that was all the top equations.
That would be I thought
that was positive.
Yes.
Okay, you got that on the bottom too, Faye? You should. Okay, so my point was, it doesn't matter which one you plug into. Okay, I would have plugged into the bottom just because the numbers are smaller if I was choosing one or the other. All right, so here we go. What's -2 times -1? -2 + 2y = 22. What do I move?
The 2, so it's going to be positive.
And I divide and I get
12.
So y = 12. So again, it didn't matter whether I chose the top equation or the bottom equation. Both of them gave me 12. Here is where you go wrong. At this point, you aren't even done with the problem. You've got to write your answer correctly. Your answer is not x equals -1 and y equals 12. Okay. When we just graphed, what was our answer?
Oh, what you call it?
I was in standard form. I just saw him slipping. So.
The question was slipping. So what was our answer?
It was an ordered pair,
right? We have to write this as an ordered pair. What is our x? What is our y? There is your answer. See how my physical
You said you're going to have to work it out or something. That's all, though.
You're just not done. You can't. What I'm saying is your answer choices aren't going to be x equals 9, y equals 7. It's going to be the ordered pair nonsense. Okay? So, if you start. to the bottom right, all of these cancel out automatically, okay? So let's look at the next one. If we add these together, what do we get rid of?
The tens,
right? What's negative 30 minus 2? Negative 32y and negative 130 plus 2. Negative 128. Okay, so you divide that, negative 32, and yes, y equals 4. Now you've got to plug in and find x. Which one do you think I would choose?
The
bottom one, because the numbers are so much smaller. Okay, plug into that bottom equation for me. Got it this time, LeBron.
You have six, and you can do
suck up into it. What's x minus 10x? Negative 9x. And what's y plus 6y?
7y.
Okay. Did anything cancel? No. That's not, like, no, we're not, we can't just add these together. The whole idea is we want something to cancel. Well, in order to cancel, what do you need, what do you know about the sides?
They have to be opposite.
They have to have one positive and one negative. All right, we'll change the first one. What do you want to change the first one to? Let's try to cancel our x's. So what number do I need in front of this x? I need a 10, right? So we're going to do that. We're going to multiply this whole equation by 10. As long as you're doing everything, you're good. Okay, that turns that equation into 10x, right?
10y.
Plus 10y 90. Equals 90. Now, that one down there. Okay. Now if I add them together, what happens to my x's? They cancel. So 16y equals 96. So y equals 6. Now, you can plug in any equation. If you wanted to plug into the one you multiplied by, you can. That's just bigger numbers. I would go back up here and I would plug in right here because 6 goes in for y, right? So x plus 6 equals 9. So what is x? X is 3. So my ordered pair answer is what? 3, 6. Please make sure x comes first. Y'all, calm down. I've done one. X plus 6. The y was 6. Right? Equals 9. I moved it, subtracted 6. 9 minus 6 is 3. You don't have to use the original equation, but the numbers are smaller if you do. I didn't multiply everything by 10. But even if you use the one we multiplied, you're going to get the same answer. Okay? I am always going to go back to the one with the smallest numbers possible. There's less error you're going to make if you're multiplying. If you're subtracting 9 to 6, it's 90 and 60 or something like that. Okay? Alright, let's look at the next one. Alright? So the first thing I want to look at is I want to see, do I have one that has opposite signs that I could go ahead and cancel? I don't have one that's exactly the same opposite signs, right? Okay. But is there one that I can change and just multiply one of my equations by a number to where they do cancel? All right. I'm going to show you both ways. Okay. I don't expect you to write both ways, so just pay attention. All right. I would have chosen one on the bottom. Two. I would have chosen, so write this one down. I would have chosen to multiply two on the bottom, which is going to give me 8x minus 2y equals negative 6, right? So now when I add my equations, what cancels? The y's cancel, so I have 9x equals negative 18, so x equals negative 2. Where do you think I'm going to plug that in? To the top, so negative 2 plus 2y equals negative 12. So 2y equals negative 10. So what does y equal? Alright, negative 12 plus 2. Negative 10. Alright, so my ordered pair would be negative 2, negative 5. Now, LeBron, what did you say? You said multiply the top by one. All right, pay attention over here. I'm going to write it on the smart board, but I'll talk through it over here. If I multiply the top by negative 4, that's going to give me negative 4x, negative 8y, and positive 48, right? And everything on the bottom would stay the same. Okay? So we're still going to get, we get negative 9y here, and we get 45. And when you divide, you divide, what is 45 divided by negative 9?
5.
-5. Did we not have -5 for a while, this one? Yes. So the difference is, LeBron would have found Y first, we found X first. That's the only difference. It doesn't matter. Okay? Are y'all paying attention?
Yes, ma'am.
And there's some people that aren't paying attention. I think they're not. Okay. All right. What you think you're going to multiply on this one? I'll multiply the bottom by positive 2. Okay? Top stays the same. Bottom becomes 8x plus 2y equals 2. So I get 2x equals 4. So x equals 2. Okay? Plug 2 back in and get your y. Somehow back to the coordinator. Alright, so you plugged in 2 and you got, what'd you get? -7. So our ordered pair here was 2, -7. Is everybody with me? Let's do one more and we'll stop at our cluster. Alright, multiply the top by 3. Okay. So y'all are starting to recognize here how sometimes it can be easy. Now, when we get into this more on Friday and Monday, it'll get a little bit more difficult trying to start multiplying 2 things here and there and negatives. But stick with this for right now. Divide by -1 and y would equal